And really, faith is like that. You have to have your experience with God. And your experience with God isn't going to be my experience. Your interpretations and your theologies and your ups and downs in lives will be different than my ups and downs. Certainly, we will have consensus on some things, and we will be able to relate in some ways. But you see through your eyes different than anybody else has ever seen through a set of eyes. You hear through your ears different than anybody else has heard through their ears. You perceive the world, you sense your surroundings different than anybody else has ever sensed that. Commonality, certainly. We can relate to one another, we can tell stories and find connections, but your experience with God is uniquely different than my experience with God. And that's a wonderful thing about grace that can meet us and reach us where we are in life. Some people look at this day and they interpret it in a literal way. That's their experience. That's their perception. That's their sense. That's their meaning of the significance of this day. Some people look at this day and they look at it in a metaphorical way. That's their experience of this faith. That's the meaning that they draw from this. Others, they look at this day, Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, the living Christ, and they look at it as a mystical experience. I like that. The mystical experience leaves room for ample mystery. For me, it leaves room for us to have differences of perception when we think about things like this, when we talk about faith. So the literal, the metaphorical, and the mystical way of seeing and experiencing God. Don't let anybody ever tell you that you see God the wrong way. Don't let anybody ever tell you that you interpret theology and doctrines incorrectly. How can they know? They don't have your eyes. They don't have your ears. They don't have your mind. They don't have your heart. Those are gifts from God to you. That's your experience. This life is your life that God has graced and blessed you with. And let God speak to you in a way that you can hear and feel and sense the love and comfort of God.